It is time to get out of here. It's time to leave sunny Florida. The van is as done as it ever will be. I had planned for it to only take a month or so, but it ended up taking like 8 months on and off. All those videos that you see on YouTube that are like, convert a van to a camper van in like 7 days, OMG, wow, are probably all lies. So now, I've finished up packing up my van. I got my 5-gallon water jug with its little pump. I've got all my food set up. I've got extra butane gas for the stove. I even indulged myself with a nice little energy drink, and I definitely gotta stop drinking those. I'm starting off with a good old rainy day. Now this is pretty typical for a Florida summer. Sun showers every day. But they normally only last for about 15 minutes or so. I'm down here looking at this footage now, and it's so bad! I don't even know how to set the camera up well yet. So what's going through my head now? Well, I'm mostly glad that I'm moving in some direction again. I spent much longer than I thought building out the van, and I'm the type of guy that does best when he keeps moving. Onto new projects, new levels, new destinations. I've got visions of Cowboy Bebop mixed with Space Dandy, and then you throw in some of the good episodes of Doctor Who. You know, that type of wandering hero character. Let's hear a little bit of what I was feeling at the moment. So the thing about being, I guess you would say, retired, is, I mean, I feel guilty. To be content, you need to be striving towards something, and, you know, you need to be working, especially at my age. I'm only 20-something. Like, I need to be doing something important, something meaningful. I need more responsibility in my life. I read somewhere where it's like the man's ultimate goal in life is to achieve freedom. And that's from different things. That's like freedom from having to work, freedom from, you know, being able to live on your own land or something. Just like be the master of your domain. And maybe I got freedom a little too soon, so I feel like I didn't earn it. Like, I have enough to, you know, live without doing anything for a while, but I feel like I'm decaying. Maybe it's a Red Queen situation where just being stagnant means you're losing the battles because everybody else is improving. So not only are you not improving yourself, but everybody's passing you by at double speed, so my pet projects really weren't enough to fulfill me, and the side work that I've been doing. Just the pure internet stuff is not... I'd really like to start a little bit more work in a team. We're gonna see how that pans out.
Man, I really didn't get how to do audio either. It looks like most of my footage, I'll have to do this charming audio dub over it. It's almost nostalgic to look back and see some of this footage now. So, I've slept in the van before. It works for that. What I haven't done is live in it exclusively, or even drive it that far. Thankfully, I've got cruise control, which is not standard for work vans, by the way. I got lucky with that. I've parked it around neighborhoods, but this will be my first real night out in the wild. I've surfed the internet and read books in it, but I also haven't done any of my real work in it. The cabinet doesn't make a perfect desk because I don't have anywhere to put my big old legs. There's lots of space to spread out my paperwork though, so that's a benefit. I should maybe do a video about the kind of work I do. If you check out my website, zachkopek.com, you can get a kind of a different vibe. I've got some of the van stuff, but you also get some of the more boring corporate stuff too. What's really interesting though are the case studies I work on. Neuromarketing, persuasion, and even some applied hypnosis into online sales. As you've seen, this is the first real vlog-type video I'm trying. They get more interesting as time goes on, so just consider this the prototype. If you've ever heard of the show Dirty Jobs on the Discovery Channel with Mike Rowe, he has a story about how he started in show business. He got his start on QVC, selling random products on late-night TV. Telling the story of how he interviewed for that, he went into it on a whim because his friend wanted the job. The guy sat him down and said, "Here's a pencil. I want you to talk about it for 8 minutes and don't stop." And that was most of the whole interview. When you're on TV, it's all about filling that dead air, even when you're just talking about the wood quality of a number two pencil. I feel like that's kind of what I'm trying to do here, trying to make a video of the road going by and trying to make that interesting. But to me, it's also a lot more than that, because it feels like you guys are all sitting alongside as I drive. So, as I start working on that, here's what past Kopek has to say.
Wow, okay, so first day on the road, first couple hours. This is like 4 hours. I'm just
So I'm starting out in St. Pete, Florida, and we're gonna go as north as possible because it's hot. It's hot in Florida even at night, and I don't like sleeping in the van when it's so hot. I mean, I've got some awesome fans that, that'll keep you kind of cool, but they drain some power, so I'm gonna see how north I can get. It is the summertime, so Georgia's still gonna be a swamp, kind of like Florida. I used to live there for 2 years in Atlanta, so I kind of know what it's like. We'll see how far I can get today. Aren't you glad you're not in the other lane? Look at that traffic. I've already driven for maybe a mile, and it's gridlocked still back here. And here's a warning sign that says low visibility ahead. Use caution. I'm not really even sure why there's low visibility. Yeah, look at this. Let's see how far it goes. Once we get over this hill, we might have a better view. Oh man, look at it. It still goes all the way down there. Whoa! Man. Yeah, so, I mean, everybody's been in long traffic like that, and it's not fun. Especially because I don't need gas, but I should probably stop, get something to eat, relax a little bit, stretch. I've already been driving for about 4 hours. So, the good thing about me living in Florida is that I've already seen all the cool stuff, so I don't really need to stop that much time and like go to Crystal River or Lake Okeechobee or anything like that. I mean, I've already seen it all. That traffic is still blocked up. Oh man, this is awful for them. Traffic as far as the eye can see. I don't know what people think of when they think of Florida, but I mean, there's a lot of empty land here. It's mostly, of course, in the Everglades, but that's more south. This is more north. This is up by Ocala. I'm a little bit past Ocala, if I remember correctly. But there's a lot of farmland, and there's just, it's as far as the eye can see. And here we have it, all the way to the Florida-Georgia line. I think that's a song or a band or something. This might be a good place to stop for the night, and it's already dark. These first couple travel videos are, like I said, probably the weakest. I was still getting into the mindset of filming things. Bear with me, since this is all videos from the past. The stuff I'm doing now, that is, in the future of this video, but the present of now, is much more interesting.